Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best of the Slot, and tonight we are going to try Birthdays the Beginning, a game I've been excited about for a really long time, but it's just hit its full release on Steam as of today. Now, this is an ecosystem-based god game that's filled with dinosaurs, more importantly than anything else. It is available now on Steam. There was a beta, I kind of skipped it just because I wanted to, you know, get my teeth into the full game when it finally came out. So, let's hop straight into new game and see what this is all about. It's a god game with an ecosystem and dinosaurs. What else do you need in your life? Nothing. One day. A day like any other day. I was reading a book when an old scrap of paper fell out. It looked like a small map. Specifically, a map of this area. And in the forest, a spot had been marked. Maybe it's a treasure map. That's how I talk. A childish notion, I know. I had no way of knowing if the map was real or not, but it didn't seem too far away, so away I... This is already very much not what I was expecting, I've got to say. For a god game, ecosystem game, whatever, I didn't expect a story per se, so I'm quite excited. Pockets of sunlight seeped through the dense canopy of trees, dimly shining my way as I walked through the dark forest. And right when I thought, I think this is the spot... I'm going to change my voice, I think. Ah, like this. A beam of light appeared before me. At that moment, I wanted to run, but my feet wouldn't budge. So there I stood, and then, as if beckoning me, the light began to move. And my feet responded in kind. I felt like a puppet. There was nothing I could do. I eventually arrived at the entrance to a cave. The light continued into the cave, and my feet continued after it. Shortly after, I lost consciousness. When I woke up, ellipses. There was a giant cube before me, next to it a smaller cube-like object, and a creature I'd never seen before. Dramatic voice. And with that, the strangest incident of my life had begun. Oh, okay, this is a change in style. Right, Navi, is that meant to be a Zelda reference? God only knows. I have HP. Why do I have HP? This is very weird. What does Navi sound like? Welcome to this unknown world! I don't have a name. No, I don't have a name myself, but if you want, you can call me Navi. That red guy is your avatar. You can give it any name you want. Boris. I've decided already. Boris. Yes. Good old Boris. Look at him. What a hero. For a long time, my job had... Seriously, it's a floating, glowing thing that gives you instructions called Navi. Whatever. For a long time, my job has been to birth life on worlds such as this one. But lately, things haven't gone right. I know everything about this world, but I can't do anything on my own. So, I called upon you. I'm sure you don't understand, but trust me, you're a chosen one. You seem confused. I just need help, that's all. I'm sure you won't let me down. If life can be birthed on this world, I can finally complete my task. And then you can return to your world. Together, we can move forward. It's our only option. First things first, you need to know the rules of this world. Now let's begin. I want to build a world and an ecosystem and I'm excited. In this world, this large pool of water that you created called it a sea. There we go, we're learning some basic stuff here, folks. On the cursor status to the right, you can see that the height is in the negatives. Can I? Oh yeah, minus 40, there we go. Everything in the negatives is the sea. Ah, okay. Well, that would make sense, wouldn't it? It's sea level. T is sea level, right? There we go. It's almost time for life to be born. Ha! If only things were that simple, but waiting around is pretty boring. Let's use an item to speed this up. Ta-da! The Breath of Life. This amazing item creates organisms. Going to say orgasms a lot, by the way, because organisms, it just happens. But you have to use it in the sea, like all orgasms. After all, that's the birthplace of all life. Okay. A broth that contains the components for... Shut up, world! Contains the components for creating life. Greatly reduces the time it takes for life to form. Jay. What have we got? What is it? Well, we're not going to see it, are you? It's going to be like a little single-cell plankton and stuff. If time flowed normally while you tried to work, things could turn better. Okay. Boop! Look at my little world! Okay. X. Phytoplankton has been born in life news. Another happy birthday! It's phytoplankton! This is said to be the original life form. Life news is displayed on the app. This is how you'll find out when new life will make sure you don't miss a single birthday. So on year 420 Blazer, phytoplankton was born. The cube status below will show you information about this world. Temperature... blah, blah, blah. Okay. More land there is, the lower the temperature. That makes sense, right? Probably. So a low water, low and wet, it gets hot. High and dry, it gets cold. There we go. At the bottom of the screen, you can change the speed at which time progress. X will start time will hear your HP, will fast forward and will consume it. Press C. Hey, look at my HP. I just want my phytoplankton to grow up all big and strong and beat up the other phytoplankton. Zooplankton! Thanks, buddy. Now, what was born was zooplankton, the first multicellular organism. It eats phytoplankton to survive. This is the first link in the food chain. Let me explain a little more about life forms. Sometimes the environment can no longer support certain species when they begin to increase in number. When that happens, the species will adapt to the environment, and through evolution, a new species will be born. Sometimes one species will appear because another has gone extinct. Life sure is mysterious. It sure is, friendo. After the third life form is born, you continue on, you can zoom in and change the trend and do all kinds of stuff, then just gonna mark on the... Make zooplankton multiply to birth stromatolite. Phytoplankton release a lot of oxygen that zooplankton need. See. Stromatolite has been born! Wow, another species was born, another birthday to celebrate. This is stromatolite, a rock-like organism made of algae that lives in high-temperature shallows. Why was stromatolite born, you ask? Because the location met the conditions for life, therefore it was born. That means you can expect them to thrive in these conditions too. Location factors, blah, blah, blah. You might want to zoom in and look for hints. Temperature, life form, prosperity, extinction, and location, location, location. It's pretty much the same as buying a house. Ish. Oh, it's nice that he knows that he's been talking for half a frickin' year. But it's fine, there's a lot of complex stuff going on. Well, not super complex, but you know what I mean. There's some stuff going on. We need to keep on top of it and know what's actually happening. The screen is micro mode. Now we've talked about the minimap before. The minimap will display the position of all... I've got a little thing over there, what is it? Animals and plants are going to display this coloured dot. I want to go see my friend. Yes. Okay, I'm going. Where is he? My little buddy! Look at him. Hi, pal. Wait. Okay, I wasn't paying attention. There we go. Oh. Give me a minute. X. Okay. Oh, B! B! Right, sorry. He did tell me how to do it and I completely didn't pay attention. That's completely on me. I'm just going to knock that back down. There we go. Oh, no, I wanted to read that more. I didn't mean to click it off. I really like the idea of building up this huge sort of encyclopedia of all these different creatures and stuff that we managed to create on our planet. That's awesome. That's how we get XP, which is how we level up. The more you capture, the more XP you gain to level up. You gain more HP. You can adjust the size of the cursor. Oh yeah, look. Okay, cool. Cool. In view mode, the minimap displays organisms that haven't been captured yet. You'll find out why that's convenient soon enough. The controls in view mode are simple. Use the left stick to move, and it says left stick, and I assume it means button, like mouse button, right? Boop! Ah! Oh no, oh no, it's... Why is it... Wait, why is it backwards? What? That doesn't make any sense. It's like inverted. It's inverted, but not for up and down. It's inverted for left and right, but not for up and down. How does that make any sense? That's bizarre. Ugh, why? What? Oh, whatever, it's fine. How was it? Oh, you're sad because nothing... No, I'm sad because of the inverted controls, you stupid crystal thing. Macro mode. Aye. Boop. Good old Boris. I hope I get to dress Boris up. Yeah. If you press N, you can change the control settings, adjust the volume, and save your data. Extinction is usually a natural part of life, but if you have saved data, what am I talking about? Well, never mind, let's just move on. To birth a new species, you need more stromatolites. If zooplankton is present, which it is, that means there are shallows, 1T to 3T. If you center flat terrain on stromatolites, it'll be easier for them. Oh, right, okay. Okay, so I've got, right, what we're gonna do, go back to micro mode, go to our stromatolites, which are down here, and we want to pull this whole area up, I think. Wait, how do I, cursor scaling, H. Okay. F. Bear with me, folks. Nope. The controls are the controls are a little bit on the fiddly side, but there's a lot of things to press, I guess. But I'm getting there. So I'm gonna try and make this all. I'm going to try and make it all a 1T shallows. So let's expand the cursor again. Like so. And that should make it much easier for the life to proliferate, right? And we can also reduce it near here. Give it lots of room to play with. That sounds like a plan. This is killing my HP, though. But that looks like plenty of room to me. So let's go back to macro mode. And start time. Boop. That goes up, and then we can fast forward. Ooh, what just happened? Ooh! Thanks, buddy. If you use a sealed life, an organism suited to that location will be born. Use this item to create a new organism, Cyclomedusa. Cyclomedusa are basically ancestral jellyfish. They live in high temperature seas and float along the water's surface. Okay, cool, let's go. How do we... buttons! So many buttons. Right, we're going this way. Okay, this is going to bug me a little bit unless I fix it. So bear with me. I still want to bear with me when I say that, but... let's just bring all this up. It's for my own sanity more than anything else. You know what I'm like with symmetry and all that kind of jazz. Well, this is going to be the same kind of thing. Oh, no. Down. There we go. Right. Okay, let's go over here. And J? No, K, and then J. A mysterious seed that can create animals from plants, greatly reduces the time it takes for animals. So, I don't think I'm always going to have these, and I think this may have happened naturally anyway, but I'm just kind of speeding up the process, you know? I'll go back to macro mode and let... Yep, in a second, I've got one more thing to do. Right trigger. Left. Yes, I did it. Okay, good. F. And then I. We're getting there. And then start time. And then speed up time. Cyclomedusa! To make a calunia out of a stromatolite. Calunia is a seaweed from the Proterozoic era. First time to micro mode. Okay, yep, I'm on it. I want to go see my... Well, oh no, they've just... It just said, right, it'll get birthed even if I don't do anything. And that something good might happen if I can do it. So now I'm thinking, oh, maybe I should wait. Where's my jellyfish? Oh, there he is, hello. Capture. Little primordial jellyfish. Look at this, adorable. Hello, beautiful. You're very fertile, I'll give you that. It's what I like in my jellyfish. Fertility. Okay. I'm just going to try just speeding up time for a bit, right? To see if we can do it without... I'm keeping an eye on my... Got a lot more jellyfish. You know what? I'm bored of this already. It's fine. It's fine. It's a tutorial. They're giving me the items. Oh, hello. Oh, I just got an item. Seed of Mutation, I think it was. We've got more jellyfish as well. Although I still only see one. Either way. I'm going to head over here. Wait, why is this... Oh, okay, whatever. We need to go into items. Seed of Evolution. Capture 15 organisms. Okay. Cursor over there. And then... J. Right. And then we need to go back. And speed up time again. Right. Kalunia! Hooray! Happy birthday! Kalunia was born. Good job. Here are 3 seeds of evolution. There's a limited number of actions. You'll use them carefully. Trilobite, that's awesome. Shallows of 48 degrees and 5,400 Cyclomedusa. Well, we've got the 5,400 Cyclomedusa. I'm not sure the shallows are going to be the right temperature. We can go check that. Let's go find out. So, zoom in. What's the temperature here? Oh, no. Mistakes have been made. Okay, one sec. Water, does it have to be specifically 48 degrees? I guess so. Okay, so I've got myself the 48 degrees, shallows water, we've got all the algae we need. It isn't actually in here visible, but you don't see all of it. Like, we've only got one piece of it, but there's actually buttloads of it. What I am confused about, right, this is the only thing that's getting... No. Now that's 48, like... This is all 48 degrees, right? I guess I've just sort of changed the general temperature of the place. I was struggling to make it all 48 degrees. Oh my god, stop doing that. this took a lot longer than it maybe looks like it probably should have, to be honest, guys. Just getting this all to be the right temperature has been an arduous process, to say the least. But now I have plenty of 48 degree water, right? Tons of algae, tons of 48 degree water. That should be enough to get ourselves a lovely trilobite. So, let's go back to macro mode. Let's start time. Just get ourselves some points, and then we're going to go whew, and speed up time loads and loads. I should have everything we need. We've got the 48 degrees, it's shallows, it's got algae, 5,000 cyclone juice, we've got loads of those. Fast forward. We're not going to use an item. I'm going to hope that this just works. Yes! There we go! Elrathia! Happy birthday, Elrathia was born. Great, it looks like you're getting the hang of this. It does, doesn't it? You finally made it this far, now it's time to move from water to dry land. You must birth the first organism to move to land, Baragwanathia. It's almost time. If this goes well, you'll be able to return to your world. This is a type of fern that breeds on land. Travelling far from its birthplace, it's the first life form that migrated to land. Lowland of 41 degrees. 6,000 Kalunia, which obviously we don't have yet, but we will get. I guess. Hopefully. And moisture 15%. Okay. So, let's go meet our new little trilobite, first of all. Where's that? There he is! Hello, buddy. Aww. Wait. Nope. Wrong button. What I want is view mode, which I think is V? Yes. Can't believe that's inverted, that is bizarre. Now, where's my little trilobite friend? Give me a minute. Give me a minute. Where's my jellyfish? There he is! Hey, pal! Look at him go, scuttling away, cheeky little lemon. You can turn around. Not a trailer, my friend. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Right. What did I just get? I just got some new items. What was it? I know I've got season mutation stuff. Oh. But you shouldn't let me use it automatically when I don't know what it is. Oh, whatever. Right, okay. So we need lowland temperature of what was it? It was higher than that, wasn't it? It was like 51, I think it was. Wait, no. Water, 41 degrees. Lowlands, moisture, 15%. Queer. Okay. I'm not going to lie that. I'm not exactly sure how to pull that off quite yet. What I'm going to do is I need to flatten this world a little bit. To make it a bit easier to actually operate in. There's a lot of sort of bits and pieces sort of sticking out everywhere after last time. After the sort of tutorial bit. So I want to clean this up if possible. The lowlands are currently 48 degrees. Moisture is 12%. It needs to be 15? Well, temperature's easy to change. I'm guessing moisture, we just have to add more water. I know I'm removing it, it's just because I want it to be neat and tidy, basically. Moisture's now... moisture's there, it's 15%. Closest to the water, right? That makes sense. Oh, stop. Woo! Okay. Oh, look at that! It's green! Got myself some algae. I guess? Right? Moisture there's 100%. Okay, I'm just gonna... We don't have the right amount of the Colonia right now, so what we should do, I guess, is just fast forward time and hope that that's gonna go up. Yeah, there we go. We need a lot more Colonia, so let's keep going with that, and hopefully the numbers keep increasing. Oh, wow, we did two? Oh, we did it! Cool! Barag Navwana. Catch right in your home free. Until then, you're free to do as you please. Just catch me whenever you're ready. This is goodbye then. Okay, let's do it. Hello, buddy. Ciao! Our very first land thing. That's the official term, by the way. Land thing. Cool. You did it! Mission complete. Our time together was brief, but it wasn't that brief. It's been 35 minutes. Go back to your world. Hooray! Oh. It would have been nice to know this was a thing. I wonder what these are important for. Oh, that worries me immensely. I mean, if I'd known those going in, I would have acted differently at the end of the day. That's fine. Is this all a dream? No, it can't be. After all, I'm in a cave right now. I should hurry home, I thought as I followed the light, but when I stepped outside, I couldn't believe my eye ear holes. The trees before me resembled thick ferns and were clearly different from the trees I had walked by previously. What is going on? Had I been taken to another world? ... question mark, exclamation mark. Perhaps I should take a look around. Oh, look at it. It's so much bigger. You know about dinosaurs, right? The famous organisms that roamed your world long ago. Your goal is to birth dinosaurs. Okay. Oh no, stop. Stop talking. Small rain cloud and strong sunlight. Oh, cool. Stop giving me all these exciting things. Yeah, they sound it. River source. Oh, cool. I want all these things. You can use a river source on any flat land, as long as it's 1 T tall and 3x3, otherwise it won't work. Right, I want to save the game. Title, save, yes, save. Click, click, save. Okay, this is weird. I did it. Title screen, yes. I just want to see what I'm dealing with in terms of kind of like click, right, what if we, save. What's challenge? I've got these little, no, I don't want to, just let me select things without clicking them. No, stop it. Right, we're just going to end it. I don't want to show you guys all this really cool stuff yet. That's down the line. Dinosaurs, look at the little cute dinosaurs. Yeah, this game is pretty cool. I like the idea of these little challenges, but clearly we've got like a campaign to work through as well. I'm going to try, you know what, I can't. Let me just, yes, right, just talk really quickly, okay? I can't not do it, okay? Because it's a freaking dinosaur. Where's he go? Hello, beautiful. You're turning away from me, cheeky little. Oh God, hello. Oh my God. But it'll feel so much more special when we've birthed our own, you know? Let's go check out this Eoraptor over here. I am really excited to just potentially play this game down the line. We are going to just work through the campaign. Our next big mission is to birth a dinosaur, so we'll do that in the next episode. If you guys want to see more, let me know if you do in the comments down below. But the best thing you can do in order to make sure we keep playing this game, which is, to be honest, a pretty awesome game, is just watch the video, tell people to watch it, and hit that like button. The more likes the video gets, the more likely we are to keep going. You know, which hopefully makes sense to you lovely folks. Look at him nomming. Oh, that is so cute. I need to go see the Ceratopsid as well. I just do. You know my love for Ceratopsids. I can't resist. It's up here, right? I love this game. Okay, cheers, much love, and as always, bye-bye.